It is very nice to be back. I need to hop off here and jump on my presentation. So what am I talking about? I truly do believe that the age of speed doesn't make things better. And a saying that really comes to mind for me is never enough time to do it right, but always enough time to do it over. So, you know, this age of speed thing is not necessarily true in all instances, but I think it's a little different. Age of speed to me is digital. It's CAD/CAM. It's doing things like that. So before I get started, this is a pretty nice place, but I'm from a pretty nice place. I'm in Monterey, California, a couple hours north of here. Actually, it's about 6 hours north and about 2 hours south. We're kind of out of the way. About 2 years ago, we got a Home Depot. That kind of is big news in Monterey. It's a town of about 35,000 people, but we have 5 prosthodontists. There were a couple of bases there, so we have a ton of dentists because it's a nice place to live. They'd rotate through on their rotations and they'd stick around. So we have a whole bunch of dentists there. It's very competitive. I'm doing just great. I love it, and I am very happy to be able to come down here, but I'm glad I don't live here. I'll tell you what. I flew in from Hawaii this morning. I took a red eye. I got in at 5:30. It was so peaceful. We went by the pantry, and I went to the pantry. I hadn't been there in 23 years. Nothing's changed. I don't know if you guys know the pantry. And how many of you know Hawaii? Anybody know Hawaii? Because I was at Side Street last night, which I've eaten so unhealthy. I had lumpak fried rice and then a big ham steak and eggs this morning. So I'm not doing real well. I got to go run. What are we talking about? The age of speed. My deal is we're going to talk a little about digital dentistry and CAD/CAM. I'm kind of known as a restorative guy and an implant person. I don't do any surgery, but I've gotten into digital dentistry. I've gotten into some CAD/CAM, which is a big thing for me, an anal prosthodontist. So what's happening? Everything is digital. There's code all around us. You know, if we go to the grocery store, if we're at Fast Pass on a bridge, I was just skiing in Alpine Meadows. Alpine Meadows, they give you a pass. You put it anywhere from your chest to your knees, and then you go up to the ski gates, and a gate opens. It's like a turnstile. And the fella says, "Hey, Curtis, how you doing this morning?" It startled me at first. I'd never seen the guy in my life. But he's on a little digi-out reader, and it's all a reader. Digital dentistry, digital everything. Everything's gone digital, and I think it's very exciting. But how do we latch on to this, and do we get past? Dental technicians and restorative and surgeons, there's a huge why in the road right now. And are you going to take the high road, the low road, technology, or are you going to let it pass you by? Is it a fad? I don't think so. But where is it going? Well, if we could, can we do things faster? Can we do it better? What are some of the things? Impressions, restorations, fabrication of not only restorations but abutments, placement of dental implants. Can we get hooked up faster and better, potentially with digital dentistry? After hours and emergencies, what's that have to do with the others? Well, it's management of your practice. Can you get it done in the same day? Diagnosis and treatment planning. You know, this is a pretty hoity meeting. This is a big time meeting. And if you talk to individuals here about high tech, these are some of the things that they may have purchased or may have bought into. The last couple years, I spent almost $200,000 going high tech with digital radiography, with a laser, with a digital system, an acquisition unit, and a mill, and nobody gave me anything. I bought it all. So, you know, is it going to be worth it? And I think it's in its infancy. That's why you have this little baby there. But if you really look at all this fancy stuff, do you realize that even though we've got all these unbelievable topics and these unbelievable people and this rapid orthodontics and all this, that 80% of dentistry is re-dentistry and 70% of restorative dentistry is posterior single unit restorations? So we're not talking to the main group of people here. This is a higher echelon of surgeon and restorative dentist who is here. This is bread and butter dentistry. So what can